I was born in China, but I moved to Oakland when I was 2. I live in the 30s. It's part of East Oakland, right off of 35th Avenue exit. If you go back a little further to like the next section, which is called the Murder Dubs, that's where I kind of grew up at. In my middle school years and some of my high school years, I would be there every day, hanging out with friends, staying over, and doing things that we weren't supposed to do. I went to my first interview with a stolen car, and I got the job. Growing up in this city, what we call like a fishbowl. We're all stuck in this fishbowl, and we don't really know what's outside of Oakland. That project area is where, you know, a lot of drugs and guns and everything that goes through there. And there's always people around the corners to make sure like the cops aren't coming through or enemies aren't coming through. And it was kind of like a weird thing because we felt safe when we came back to Oakland. Every time we left somewhere, we're like, oh, let's go back. Now we feel safe. My grandfather was a photographer. He actually passed away before I was born. So I stayed with my grandmother because she was by herself, and living with her, all his photos were on the walls. Like, so that's what I seen growing up. Pictures are around the world, of like different parts of China, Vietnam, Thailand, stuff like that. But it wasn't until her passing and a lot of my friends were like getting locked up or getting killed. And I was like, I wish I had more memories of them. And that's the same thing like with my grandmother. I was like, I wish I had more memories of her because I always hung out with her, but like, they're just thoughts in my head. There's no pictures and stuff like that. So it wasn't until after she passed where like, I told myself I'm gonna get a camera, and I got one and I fell in love right away. It was just weird to leave the city because none of us were experienced to do that. But once we got older and got to experience more and more and more, we realized how beautiful it is around the world. And it's something that you don't see on the news because you just hear about like terrorist attacks or things that happen around this part of the world. And you're like, why would I even want to go? But once you got to experience and actually see it, you know, you just want more of it. And growing up, I never really had that. So being able to see that odor is awesome. So I picked up my first camera, it was a Nikon, I believe. It was mostly pictures of hanging out with friends, just like at parties, at our outings or whatever. I felt like that's what Instagram was for a while. And it was just a social thing. And it wasn't until like a year later that I realized like, you know, there's millions of people seeing these images every day. And this should be a good way to get my work out. But it's also cool because I can go to anywhere around the world and know that I can meet somebody up, or I can hang out with them and their families, and that's a cool thing about the app that I like. I'm always out there shooting, just because it's something I want to master one day, you know? Like, I feel like I'm always going to be a student, and this is something I always want to get better at. I'll take my time and spend hours to try to capture a new angle or try to see different places that in that area that I haven't seen yet. Just because you see so much photos online, and you pretty much get that stuck image in your head, all right, I'm going to go get that shot. I try not to do that just because that shot's been overshot a million times. I usually don't edit until a week to a month later. It's weird. I don't know if I'm the only one that does that, but I don't like editing right away. Try and put that distance so I can, when I go back, I appreciate the image a lot more than what it was from that day. Because I'm already excited that I took the photo, but if I edit it and post it out, I'm kind of forget about it. If I go back to it, then I'm like, oh wow, I remember this day exactly, clearly.
What's next?
I don't know. It's the longest I've been back for a while. I just want to stay put and just relax for a bit. When I come back, I'm always seeing like friends for the first time in like a a year or a couple months, so we're always talking about like the past and the things that happened. So those are the times I always look back and look at photos. I went to San Francisco the other day to shoot for like the first time in a few months. I met up with a few friends, but we were all in the same boat. We were tired of San Francisco for about, you know, way too much photos from here. We went to Marshall Beach. It's over there by the Golden Gate. And yeah, it was one of those sunsets that were like amazing that you rarely see in San Francisco. When I travel so much, when I come back, I'm always seeing like friends for the first time in like a year or a couple months. So those are the times I always look back and look at photos and talk about the good times, and then also think about where we're heading now. Cause I don't know, we're all doing good things. We want to keep it that way and just keep going forward.